would like to just tell you for a moment, I did it. I hate to say television, this is a movie night, but I swear to God, 2 weeks ago, I did a television show, and they gave me a dog to work with. Not a good idea. It was a Maltese, and I called it Falcon. See, right down into the movie, you notice how I wrote that? But I swear to God, they gave me this dog, and they put it in my lap, and they wanted the dog to, we were trying to get a still picture. So the dog is looking straight ahead, or we wanted to. I'm looking it straight ahead. All of the dog is going, I thought, we're never going to get this. The wrangler, the dog wrangler, came over to me, and he said, Miss Cook, may I help you with that? We want to calm him down. We want him to be placid. I said, good thing. He said, may I help you? I said, of course. He said, put your hand under his chin. Then take your hand and work it all the way down his stomach. And then caress his testicles. That dog was like this, and suddenly it went. I said, would that work on a human being? Of it, but how about this? This will ring your bell. The miracle worker, water. 30 years we've been doing this show, and I've told you, there's not a deaf person in the audience. Thank you. You know how David Galligan gets us all to do this show. He says, if you don't do this show for me, you will never work for free in this town again. When I first started out in New York, there was a wonderful little club called Number One Fifth Avenue. Some of you may remember it, and they, thank you. It's a wonderful club. It was very big on starting people in careers. And they held a contest. And the prize, if you won, was a week's work at Number One Fifth Avenue. Well, I won the contest, but there was one little problem. I didn't have an act. I just had the one number that I had won the contest with. So I did my week's work. And it was fun. It was New York to me. I loved it. And I had time, because I didn't have an act, to watch the people in the club. I sat near the back door. And every night, this woman would come in, not heavily made up, did not sit at the bar. She sat in the back table. She would order a drink, and she came at 9 o'clock on the dot. The 7 days I worked there. She was a slight woman, and sort of an illusion of beauty. She was of a certain age. Her hair, I'm sure, was gray, but under those wonderful lights, it looked ash blonde, and she looked young. I never heard her speak, but the most amazing thing about her was she wore a very breezy dress. And you know what it looked like to me? You know what a doily is, or an antimacassar? Your grandmother or your aunt had put on the arms of a chair. And it was usually made out of very flimsy linen with embroidery. And all around the edge was tatting. And she looked as if to me she had sewn a lot of doilies together. And she seemed to waft into the place. I never knew her name, and as I said, I never heard her speak. But this is for the lady who dressed in doilies. And in my mind, she was a movie. And I could tell something was going on in her mind. She was probably reminiscing over the movie of her life. Something cool. I'd like to order something cool. It's so warm here in town, and the heat gets me down. Yes, I'd like something cool. My, it's nice to simply sit and rest a while. Now I know it's a shame I can't think of your name. I remember your smile. I don't ordinarily drink with strangers. I most usually drink alone. But you're so awfully nice to ask me, and I'm so terribly far from home. Like my dress, I must confess, it's very old, but it's simple and neat. It's just right for the heat. Save my furs for the cold. A cigarette Well, I don't smoke them as a rule, but I'll have one. It would be fun with something. I bet you couldn't imagine that I one time had a house with so many rooms I couldn't count them all. I'll bet you couldn't imagine I had 15 different beaux who would beg and beg to take me to a ball. I'll bet you couldn't picture me the time I went to Paris in the fall. And who would think the man I loved was quite so handsome, quite so tall. Well, it's true, it's just a memory I had, one I almost forgot, because this weather's so hot and I'm feeling so bad about a date. Stop to buy me something.